Good morning and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're gonna have a look at the brand new Ferrari Roma that was introduced today in, where else? In Rome, of course. So the first impressions I had when I first saw this car, it was the three-quarter front view. I thought this has to be a new Aston Martin. It looks really good and it has those typical Aston Martin proportions, but I was wrong, it's a Ferrari Roma. So what we're gonna do in this video is we're gonna do an experiment. I'm gonna take the Ferrari Roma, throw it into Photoshop, and remove all of the graphical elements of the car. We're going to remove the headlights, the grille, the logos, and all of this. We're gonna do the same with a few other sports car models. And by doing that, we're really gonna have the proportions that we compare. So we're gonna compare the proportions of a few different cars and see if they really are that alike or not. So here's the thing with making a two-door GT car. It's been done so many times before and it's been done over decades. So coming up with a new format and a new design for a two-door front engine GT car is very hard. It is going to resemble something that's been done before, since we can't change the package of the car. It's still going to have a big engine in the front, and that determines how the front is going to look like, and it needs seating for two people. That determines how the greenhouse is going to look like, and then you have the overall shapes and dimensions and regulations of what a car is supposed to be, and all the measurements and heights and so on, and where the lights are supposed to be. There are a lot of regulations that go in to designing a car. So manufacturers today, or designers today, they do have kind of their hands tied in some aspect of designing cars, and I think that's going to change with electric cars. But since we're still in this era of conventional cars, that meaning you have an engine, transmission, and all of these parts that still needs to fit inside of the car, the car design is not going to change radically, because simply you can't. You need to fit all of these pieces inside of the body of the car. So no matter what type of car you come up with, it's still going to resemble something that's been done before. And sometimes it feels like car manufacturers are going round and round in circles. You have a trend that lasts for 5-6 years. That lasted 15 years ago, and then all of a sudden you see those trends coming back today, because there's nowhere else to go. You need to fit all of these design features within these regulations. So the same trends come and go, and I think that's what we see here with this Ferrari Roma. We see the same kind of design, or style of the design, or the design language, as we did with the 612 Scaglietti and the Ferraris of the 2000s. And that's what I want to show you with this experiment here. We're going to remove all of the badges, the grille, all of the distinct graphical features of the cars, to see the proportions and the pure sculpture of the cars and see how much they really are alike. Alright, so here we are. We have now depersonalized these three cars, and I think it's interesting to see, because when we remove all the graphics and all this stuff, all the trim pieces and stuff like that, then we really get to the proportions of the car, and that's when we can start to compare the design of the car. So to me, the reason that I thought it was an Aston Martin is because of one single line, and that is this line that goes right here, which is a typical Aston Martin line, and that's this one right here, this line. And it's not really on, they don't really implement that in the newer Aston Martins, as you can see down here on the new Vantage, but they did have it on the DB9 from 2010-ish and something like that, and also of course the Virage, that was a very short-lived model, but that had a very distinct front flare down here, and this part right here, this line that goes into the side of the car, and that's the reason why I thought this was a 100% an Aston Martin when I first saw it. And on top of that, the new Roma has this Aston Martin-like front design that goes like this. So we have almost an Aston Martin grille integrated in the shape of the design, and the shape of the window here, this part right here, is also very Aston Martin-like. But, you know, you have this in the F-Type, you have this in a bunch of different sports cars today, so The way that you set yourself apart from your competitors is by design, and I guess today it has a lot to do with graphics and how you implement graphics in your design. Because if we strip them down like this, this could be pretty much any brand you want. If we make some Jaguar headlights on here, or some Aston Martin headlights, this could definitely be an Aston Martin. This could probably not be a Ferrari because the new Vantage has this high shoulder line, and it has a very distinct shoulder line that doesn't have a dip right here that most sports cars has in this segment. So that's a new thing that Aston Martin came up with, and it sets the Vantage apart. So we have this continuous line that goes right here. That's pretty unusual because it makes this point very high compared to other cars in this segment. If we compare it to these two, for example, the Roma and the Alfieri down here. But the Alfieri is another design like this that is very generic when you remove all the graphics. This could also be an Aston Martin. If we put some Aston Martin graphics on there, we can definitely turn it into whatever sports car we want. One specific feature of this Alfieri is this line right here. This is very Maserati, and it's what sets this apart from the rest of the cars in this experiment that we're doing today, is the window line. So the C-pillar has always have this straight line on most Maseratis, but again, that's just a tiny detail that doesn't really affect the design in a big way, and especially not the proportions of the car. The thing is, the proportions of the car is kind of timeless. If we go back to, for example, the Ferrari 250 GTO, that is one of my favorite cars of all time, one of the most beautiful cars of all time, along with the 275 GTB /4. Those have the same proportions as we see today. And the same thing with the Daytona. It gets some Daytona vibes from the new Roma as well. And that's not a bad thing. It feels like from 2010 forward, Ferrari went into this experimental type of design with the A12 Superfast. Yeah, I think it started with the FF when they started to implement these deep creases in the side of the car. The 458 had some of that, but not too much. And then we have the A12 Superfast, and now we have the Pista and all of these cars that have very deep creases in the side of the body. But it feels with this Roma here that Ferrari is going back to the traditional Italian styling. And it feels like by doing that, they are actually positioning themselves more along with other car brands and car designs, because when you had these creases and waves in the design that we have, that we've seen in the recent Ferraris, that was the design language that set Ferrari apart. But that's only been around for a couple of years or a decade or so. So this is going back to the traditional way of styling the 612 Scaglietti, the 550 Maranello, the 575 Maranello. And I like it. It's not a bad looking car. The problem is the proportions of the car and the styling of the car is such a timeless design that you can't go wrong with it. And that's why so many car manufacturers use these proportions, but at the same time, it becomes difficult to set yourself apart from the competition. I just quickly want to touch on the rear view of the new Roma as well. It does look a little bit like the Aston Martin Vantage, more so I think in the rear than it does in the front. The big difference here in proportions when it comes to these two cars is this rear fender. You see on the Ferrari, it bulges out like this and creates this strong looking rear end with the power in the back. But on the Vantage here, you see that we have this straight line that we were talking about earlier that doesn't really have this powerful rear. Instead, it looks more planted in the back, and that creates a different style of the car, and the proportions of the car are not the same. But the graphics, on the other hand, when we talk about the graphics there, that's when we have all these very similar designs graphically. So for example, we have this part right here that goes down here that creates a sort of a shelf there. The only difference here is that on top we don't have that integrated ducktail on the Ferrari like we have on the Aston Martin, but we still have the shelf down here. That's the same, and the graphics for the exhausts and the diffuser down here is pretty similar right here. If you look, we have some more organic shape on the Aston Martin, but the general idea is still the same. But the first thing I thought when I saw the Roma from the rear was, actually, this might shock some people, but I thought it looked a lot like a Porsche 911 for some reason. I'm not sure why, but that was the first thought when I first saw it, which I thought was kind of interesting because Porsche, as we know, have a very distinct rear end. But something about the Roma just triggered some Porsche thoughts when I first saw it. So that's the design dissection of the Ferrari Roma and my opinion on it. I think it's a good looking car, but as I said,
The proportions and the styling is very timeless, and the only difference that I see here that makes it a modern car from 20 years ago or 10, 15 years ago, or if we go back even to the 60s, is the graphical elements. The rest of the proportions, nothing really new there, and that does make sense because this is what a GT, two-door GT car is supposed to look like. You have the long hood and the low nose and almost that fastback feeling of the greenhouse. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for spending a few minutes with me today. I'm the Sketch Monkey. Let me know what you think about this Ferrari Roma. Is it too much of a copy of other brand, or do you think Ferrari did a good job by separating themselves from other brands? Let me know in the comments below. I'll see you in the next video. Take care.